Namaste everyone. Today I'm going to discuss about the Tessier classification of craniofacial clefts. This is just for the completion of the previous discussions we had in cleft lip and palate. So as we go along, I will draw and outline the clefts that are seen in this commonly used classification, which is again important from the examination point of view. It's easy to just sketch out the midline first. Draw a soft tissue outline on one side and the bony outline on the other side, and then proceed so that you can compare the clefts also as we draw them. So the clefts are classified into four categories, which are the midline or the median clefts, paramedian, the orbital, and then the lateral clefts. So we will start first with the midline clefts. So there are 0 to 14, that is total number of 15 on soft tissue side or the bony side. So the number 0 that is there, it actually lies somewhere here in the midline. And there is the number 14 cleft, which is at the top. And there is actually another cleft, which is called number 30, which is depicted here below. So the reason for this is that the midline clefts are 0, which bisects the maxilla and the nose. Number 14 is occupying the frontal and the nasal region. And number 30 cleft is the one which is through the tongue, the lower lip, and in the mandible. And in a lot of these cases, a common clinical finding can be something as simple as a tongue tie, or there can be an entire hypoplasia of these regions or abnormalities in the tongue. So these are the main midline clefts. Now the paramedian clefts are number 1 and 2, which are commonly seen where in the region of the cleft lip and palate. These are the ones that are seen. So number 1 is over here, and number 2 is a little laterally on the side, but they are along the nasal region. Now you have to know that there are certain discrepancies between exact location of the soft tissue cleft and of the underlying bony cleft, but they are depicted almost in the similar way. So number 1 lies over here, number 2 lies here. Similarly, on the bony side, we have number 1 extending from the nose down till here. So the lines depict the line of extension of the cleft, and number 2 is on its side. Now corresponding to them, there is also number 12 and number 13, but they are on the more cranial side. So in correspondence to number 1, we have number 13 over here. Similarly, from the nasal region to the frontal region here, all the way to the top, we have number 13. That's why I'm using the similar colors to show how they correspond to each other. Then there is number 12 corresponding to number 2, which is in the medial orbital region, closer to the midline though. And similarly here, there is number 12. Okay. So now, these are the main ones which are in the paramedian regions. Now these paramedian clefts are the ones that are still close to the midline. So beyond that, what we will have now are going to be the orbital clefts. So now for the orbital cleft, we have the ones that are starting. They actually start from the region, like such as in the lip, the number 3 cleft starts, and it extends through the nose all the way till the orbital region. And it actually corresponds here to number 11. Similarly, we have number 3 over here, which is extending from the orbital region down. That is number 3. And it is extending upwards where number 11 would be. Similarly, we have number 4 and number 10. So more lateral to number 3. Extending to the orbital region, extending to the orbital region is going to be number 4, and on top with the cranial extension is number 10. Similarly, on the bony side we have number 10 and its extension below is number 4. Now we also have number 5, which is again extending. So what you need to remember is from where they begin. So like 3, 4 and also 5, they have extensions along the lip region, but 5 stops over here on the soft tissue side. And number 9, which is also an orbital cleft, is over here. Whereas in the bony side, number 5 is actually going all the way to the orbit and number 9 is over here. Now what we are left with is actually the simpler lateral clefts. So they are the ones that are in the lateral region, and they are in fact the more commonly associated ones which are seen in the syndromes. So we have number 6 over here, which is coming from the region of the orbit, though it extends laterally. And from the lateral canthal region we have number 8. So 6 and 8 are over here, whereas the long lateral cleft that is extending from the angle of the mouth till the ear, till the auricle region, is number 7, or you can say it's coming from this lateral region here and extending till the angle of the mouth. Similarly, on the bony side we have number 6 over here in the orbital region. Number 7 you can see is going through the mandible region, and it's in the lateral area of the zygoma, maxilla and mandible. And number 8 is again in the lateral region. So these are all the clefts that are seen in Tessier. What you need to remember is that they are divided into midline, paramedian, orbital and the lateral clefts. Now the points that you need to remember are that for the lateral clefts, number 6, 7 and 8 are very important, because these three together are seen in Treacher-Collins syndrome, which is again a relatively common syndrome that we see. The number 7 one is associated with craniofacial microsomia, which is also the first second mandibular arch syndrome, or the mandibulofacial dysostosis. So in that there can be macrostomia, there can be preauricular abnormalities, and there can obviously be the underlying bony abnormalities as well. And number 8 is the one which is related to golden hair syndrome, in which epibulbar dermoids are commonly seen. So this is commonly what you need to know, an overview of the Tessier classification. There is yet another craniofacial classification, which is called the Van der Meulen classification, in which the division is as per the embryogenesis. So whether the dysplasia is in the intranasal region, nasal maxillary region or the maxillary region, according to that. There is information about it in Google if you search it, in Wikipedia. So that is the less commonly asked one. Since this is the common one, I have discussed that. So I hope this was helpful in getting an overview of this classification.